Hello everyone, today we are going to start a new chapter number 5 of NCERT book. It is about data handling. So in this chapter you will learn about presentation of data, bar graph, histogram, pie chart and probability. You know, the statistic is a branch of mathematics which deals with collection, presentation, analysis and interpretation of numerical data. The collection of numerical facts regarding a particular type of information is called data, and each numerical fact is known as observation. Now next is how to represent data. So first we can observe an example in which the marks obtained out of 100 in mathematics by 20 students in order of their roll numbers. So first what we have to do is to arrange this data in ascending order. So after arranging this ascending order, you come to know that 45 occurs one time, 55 one time, and same way you can see that 85 occurs two times. So we can arrange this in a table, and this table is known as a discrete frequency distribution table. Now there is one more way of representing the data. It is the grouped class interval. And now let's see an example in which the marks out of 50 obtained in English by students of class 8th having 40 students. These marks are given according to the roll numbers. Now let's consider a frequency table taking groups, means that is grouped frequency distribution table. So in this, class intervals are given from 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 and so on. So let's consider first class interval, that is 0 to 10. In 0 to 10, you can see the marks will be counted from 0 to 9 and 10, whereas 10 will be not included in that class interval, 10 will be included in second class interval, that is from 10 to 20. Similarly, 20 to 30 also, 20 will be included in third class interval, not in second. So in first class interval, that is from 0 to 10, how many students are there whose marks are from 0 to 9, and so it is 3. In second class intervals, you can check the number of students whose marks are from 10 to 19, so they are 12. So this type of frequencies, this type of table is called group frequency distribution table. Now how to represent the data in a pictorial form? So that first is bar graph. You already know what is a bar graph. Bar graph is a pictorial representation of numerical data in the form of rectangles of equal breadth and varying height. So you know already, you studied in lower classes how to make a bar graph. Now next is how to make a histogram. Histogram is also one type of bar graph. Bar graph where the class intervals are shown on the horizontal axis and the heights of the bar shows the frequency of the class interval. It is a vertical bar graph with no spacing between the bars. So this is the histogram. Now let's start exercise 5.1. It is very easy. I have given solution also. You can go through it and check your answer and do it in your fair. Thank you.